Hi everyone, Mike Gerholt here, Button Click Admin, and I am pleased to be joined this week with Justin Edelstein, who is the founder of Arkus. He's also a podcaster, and you can catch his podcast every week. It's called the Cloud Focus Weekly, and so far they've done 85 episodes, so it's nice to talk to a fellow podcast/blogger. So welcome, Justin.
Thanks, Mike. Thanks for having me. Really appreciate it.
So for those people that aren't familiar with Arkus or what you guys do, can you kind of briefly sum up what you do and what you have out there?
Sure. So Arkus is a Salesforce consulting partner. We've been around for a little over 2 years now, working with primarily financial services institutions as well as nonprofits to help them implement and improve upon their existing Salesforce.com instances.
Cool. And I think I saw you in the MVP group too, did I not?
This is true. We hang out in the MVP group from time to time, you and I.
So we're going to actually jump back a ways, back to Winter 11, when permission sets came out. Because as a button click admin, I love them. I've just recently had a chance to use them. They're good when you have people that are in a fixed position, but maybe have to backfill for someone else. And that actually happened in my company. We had somebody go on leave for a little bit, and they only need temporary permission to a certain area. So I like them for that reason. But I wanted to talk to Justin a little bit about permission sets, because I think they're the future of doing profiles in Salesforce. But I can also see some of their limitations, too.
Yeah, I agree. I think the specific example that you gave is one really great use case for permission sets. The ability to pilot new applications or new objects or records within Salesforce, very useful to use permission sets. I mean, I used to be an admin just like you, a button click admin, and I can't even tell you how many times somebody would shoot me an email and say, hey, I really want to be able to edit this field. And I'd say, oh, well, okay, let me look. Oh, you have a profile that is the same as 53 other people who can't edit that field. And now I have to come up with some way, shape, or form to allow you to edit that field, or I have to tell you no. Yep. And, you know, we don't like to tell people no all the time. So with permission sets, really nice way to very granularly, at an ad hoc basis, give people the ability to do certain things that their permission says that they currently can't do.
Cool. So the teaser then is this should be out right about the time that you guys have a cool app hitting the App Exchange for permission sets. So can you tell me a little bit about that?
Sure. It's called The Permissioner. And we've noticed through the last bunch of months in dealing with a bunch of customers and clients that, you know, we've been teaching them and educating them about permission sets, and we'd show them and they'd love it. And then, you know, they'd have about 30 to 40 users that they'd want to assign a permission set to. You know, very simple permission set, like edit three fields on a specific object. And we'd say, oh, that's great. Let's use a permission set for it. And then when it comes time to assign that permission set to those 30 or 40 users, it became a headache. The reason being, right now, there's no really good way to mass assign a permission set to any user. So you have to go one by one, user by user, clicking through and basically hitting that assign related or the related list to assign permission sets and add the permission set to that user, hit save, and then on to the next user. As an administrator, that's a lot of time to click through. You know, if you're a developer and you want to use the developer workbench tool, you can do that. But again, now you're messing with files and IDs and things. And typical admin just wants to, you know, give me a user interface. Let me click through. Let me find the people I want to assign this permission set to, and let me assign it to them. Cool. So that's what we set out to build with the permissioner, a really nice, simple search interface where you go to a tab called the permissioner inside of Salesforce. You search for a permission set or permission sets, choose the ones that you want to assign, and then search for users based on a number of criteria, whether it be the name, their username, their profile, their role, maybe a public group that they're in or a queue that they belong to. Find these sets of users, you know, a couple hundred of them or just five. Select them and hit the assign button. And all of a sudden, you've assigned however many permission sets you've chosen to the users that you've selected, all on one screen, really simple two-step process, all audited, all logged in the Salesforce audit log, and we actually send out an email to the person who did the action, letting them know exactly what they did in case they made a mistake.
Very cool.
In case they had to show it to some.
So, and I think that's, you know, sometimes we see that with Salesforce where they roll out a feature and then they forget about, well, what happens when you have to give it to 200 people, you know? So looking ahead, we're on the heels of the summer release. Any speculation as to what maybe cool features we're going to see in summer 12?
We can speculate. Safe harbor always applies, right? I feel as if we're going to see, again, just a lot of chatter and enhancements. This seems to be the trend over the last bunch of releases, chatter, chatter, chatter.
Yep.
I feel like chatter now is going to hit hit the orgs where we're going to be able to instant message each other right within Salesforce. That will be pretty neat, pretty cool. I know at Arkus we use Google Talk to communicate with each other in that way, but we're always struggling with, you know, do we Google Talk that? Do we email each other? Do we chatter? So, you know, I could see chatter now kind of taking over for that Google Talk aspect of that kind of communication with one another. Some other things that I imagine will be coming down the pipeline, you know, we'll obviously see some enhancements to the new, you know, site.com, Siteforce. Looking to get my hands on that, see what we can do with building some websites with some clicks. And I think that we're going to probably see, I'm actually in the pilot right now for it, but I think we're going to see, it go GA is the many contacts to one task, which
we've
will be
wanted that for a while.
Yeah. That's one of the most asked for ideas on the ideas exchange that I can remember. So I think we're going to see that finally come to fruition. It'll be nice, I think, to see that come with events, because personally, I assign more contacts to events than I do to a specific task, but hopefully that'll come following in its footsteps after summer.
Cool. Well, Justin, I want to thank you for being on Button Click Admin. I'm going to put a link down below to your podcast, and I hope everybody goes out to the App Exchange and tries out the permissioner, especially if you have more than two users.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.